So let me ask you a question then. What are the chances of Kevin Owens showing up in AEW?
Yeah, that will happen. I'm surprised he was moved so high up in the draft because he doesn't want to stay there. And also, to piggyback off what you said, it did look like they were going in a direction where Sammy was going to be in Dominic's ear. But Sammy is now on a different brand to Ray and Dominic. Like, Sammy's on
really?
SmackDown. Yeah, so...
That's weird.
So all these... And he's another guy whose contract's coming up at the same time. So
who's?
Sammy.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we got...
He would probably leave too, you think? Because he's part of that Young Bucks, Southern California...
Leaving?
Because all their friends are in AEW. Because Adam Cole, Young Bucks, all those guys, that's that PWG indie crew, you know, that made indies hot in the 2018.
And Ring of Honor guys, you know, those.
Right,
guys.
And now they're all in AEW together. Like, they're all boys, bro.
Yeah, and that's that's the thing. Like, I mean, they're not getting pushed in WWE necessarily. So there's not enough space for them to get pushed in AEW either. I mean, we can see what Punk's doing and like to get.
Not only that, bro, if you look at the AEW show, look at how many quick segments they had to have, you know, like talking segments and backstage segments.
Yeah, like little 1 minute kind of, things for guys
like,
to do nothing for.
Don't forget that these people are on the show. Well, bro, it's almost, you know, when you're dedicating 30 seconds to this, it's very easy to forget, but go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, with the Punk thing, I've got to where Disco was a month ago where he said that he needs to be facing this guy and that guy, and I didn't agree at the time. But now I think it's just,
disagree. I don't want to learn that disagreeing with me is not very good for your credibility. I'm usually right about these things.
He's not.
At the time, I think I was correct with saying Darby was fine as a first choice, but and then I think they really, Hobbs was fine for television, but this guy, Garcia on Rampage, you could hear people boo it when he was announced. So I don't understand why you're going this slow. Like, it's okay.
Well, not to mention last night. He hears the criticism. He addressed the criticism. And it's like you could... Joe, what was the crowd like when Punk said, Daniel Garcia, like, let's do this, where he challenged Daniel Garcia to match? What was the reaction of the crowd?
It was mixed. I think just because he offered the crowd, I'm either going to give you all a cheesesteak or I'm going to wrestle. And, you know, of course, the sarcastic crowd was like, we want cheesesteaks, you know? So then when he announced he was going to wrestle instead of giving away free food, there was booze, yeah. But other than that,
the fact that it was Daniel Garcia had nothing to do with it.
I don't think it helped. No, it didn't help. But
give me a break.
Yeah.
I mean, people are sitting there saying, dude, it's like you touted.
Do you want it? Do you want cheesesteaks or do you want me to wrestle some guy nobody really knows?
Let's hypothetically speak.
He set himself up for that.
If you took AJ McKee, okay, and signed him from Bellator, do you know who AJ McKee is, Conan?
No.
I know the name.
AJ McKee is one of the best featherweights in the world. He wrestles in Bellator. The guy is fantastic. Okay, he's definitely, he could, he's got a mouth. His father's a fighter too, and he just wiped out Pitbull, who's like Pitbull's like the Bellator legend, right? He just killed him, and like he looks fantastic, and like people look at him like, wow, this guy should be in the pound for pound conversation. It's like if you brought him in the UFC, and like he's got all this hype, and like his first three fights are against absolute nobodies. Like that's what Punk is doing right now. It's like the fans, like they're being so arrogant. Thinking that, like, okay, people will just pay to watch Punk wrestle. It's like, no, people want to see him wrestle somebody. I mean, that's still like they're really. I think what they're doing, they're misinterpreting like the interests of the basic fan. You know, the basic fan does not care just to watch a guy work. The basic fan wants to see, like, you look at the shows when there's marquee matchups. The shows do better. When the show has a title, the shows do better. But these shows where Punk's just wrestling mid-card guys and challenging mid-card guys, I mean, honestly, if this was an actual combat sport, he'd come across as a pussy. As a pussy. Conan, like, dude, why are you challenging all these underneath guys? It doesn't make any sense.
Someone thinks what Disco's saying, right? Is anybody in a position to go up to Tony Khan from your experience and actually say, I don't think this is right. I don't think we should be doing this. I think we should be moving this along. Like, is anybody in a position where they can question the booking?
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. And but I think I almost get the feeling sometimes, bro, when I'm back there that everybody's so happy that they're getting paid and everybody's so happy. Nobody wants to make waves. And I know Tony reads everything. Okay, so he's aware that people might not be happy at this. But this, I think, I feel from what I surmise, are Punk decisions. You know what I'm saying? And he probably wants to respect him, doesn't want to, you know what I'm saying, make any waves with Punk right now.
With Punk being on commentary, CM Punk wants to commentate. Is that what you think?
Probably. I don't think Tony asked him to do it. I don't know. You know, you're asking me something I don't know. But I do know this, that from the very beginning, I was aligned with Disco on this. You know, you need to fight big name guys. Darby was cool to begin with. It should have been somebody bigger. Darby was cool, but this, I want to fight Hobbs and Garcia and all these other young cats because, you know, when I was young, you know, nobody helped the young guys. And look at WCW, what happened. All those guys stayed there. That's fine, cool, and dandy, but not right now, not one right after another. People want to see the big matchups, and people want to see you be ornery on the microphone, not come out and ask, hey, are you guys tired of the love fest? Of course they're going to say no, because you just got back. You're still in your honeymoon period, and that right now people are popping nuts every time they see you, but that's going to get old fast. So you need to be ornery, what got you to the game, and you need to do big matchups. Then if you want to fight a young guy, you can. You know, like Danielson did. He fought Omega, then yesterday he did a match where, you know, on the other side was
the Bucks, Kenny, and Cole. And, Cole, yeah.
Yeah, but he tagged up a Luchasaurus and Jungle Boy and kind of gave them the rub. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's cool, but at least he's, you know what I'm saying? Fighting.
Let me give you a perfect example. I got a tweet here, okay? And this is where me and Conan have said, and we've been since day one, that these guys are in positions that they've never done before. They're being very self-congratulatory. Okay, like when they do good numbers and everything, and I'm just going to say this tweet. This is from August 19th, okay, from Tony Khan. I'm betting that this is his words, right? I'm betting that the excitement from the most anticipated announcement in AEW history at AEW Rampage, the first dance, will build up through All Out on pay-per-view, will make new fans, and will welcome dormant wrestling households worldwide back into the fold. A new era in hashtag AEW begins tomorrow. This is the week before the Punk announcement, right? So this is the last 4 weeks of their numbers from September. That's August, okay? We're supposed to, like, these guys are planted their flag. We're going to, I'm not sure in the new era, okay? This is the last 4 weeks. 1.175, 1.273, that was the Kenny and Brian match. Last week, 1.152. This week, 1.050. Another 10% drop. Since we've been very critical of some of the decisions they've made, can we argue that they need to admit that they were wrong in their assessment of what bringing Punk and these guys in would do with their numbers? Have they been wrong? Yes or no? Do you think so? Do you think they've been wrong? I think they've been wrong. And I think the numbers are very obvious. And I'm telling you why they're wrong is because you wasted your most important guy, which is CM Punk, doing mid-card the guy. Nobody cares. Literally, nobody cares about CM Punk wrestling Daniel Garcia. And if you think like dormant households are going to come back in the fold to watch Daniel Garcia wrestle CM Punk, I'm just saying I completely disagree, and I'll provide my evidence. And like, the evidence is very clear. The fans are not watching. You know, they're not buying this. They're disinterested. You know, they've lost. Well, the Punk debut was 1.3 something million, right?
Yeah.
Well, they've lost over 25% of the fans since then.
Bro, it's the same thing. Like, if today, let's say Triller, right? You know how now that they're not doing the fight with the Mech, with the Puerto Rican guy?
They try to get it, yeah.
Right. Billy, it's like if today it came out that Triller signed Conor McGregor, right? And his first fight is against Daniel Garcia or some you never heard of. You're like, then what the did you sign him up for? You know, Punk should have come on top, fighting the top guys, and their ratings would be higher than they are right now. I truly believe that. You know what I'm saying?
They absolutely would. They absolutely would.
I think in wrestling is different because Conor McGregor, when you sign a prize fighter, you know they're only going to have four or five fights over the course of 2 years. But wrestling's different. But I still don't agree with the fact that, okay, you start with Darby, but now you're going down. Like, Darby was the starting point. It needed to have an upwards trajectory.
Darby's top of the middle card. Right. Like, he's the guy on the upper echelon of the mid card guys, at the top of the mid card.
Right.
Ready to come
in. Who's next? The guy that doesn't rap on the Acclaimed? I mean, what's next? You know what I'm saying? So
there would have been more interest if he'd actually wrestled Colt Cabana. At least there's a story.
Right. Well, at least they have a past.
This is where rookie bookers make a mistake, okay? And wrestling's been this way for so long. Okay, and it didn't used to be like this, but back in the territory days, it was like this. But it's changed drastically since there's been so much TV. You're not giving a guy a rub just by letting him work with you. The rub comes when you put the guy over. Like Punk, if he's giving these guys a rub, they need to beat him. That's the rub. The rub isn't just working with the guy. Nobody gets elevated by losing. Nobody right. gets elevated.
I just think we'll put Christian Cage with this guy. That's going to automatically elevate that whole group. We're going to put in Matt Hardy with these guys, guys that don't look like they should even be together, Billy. I mean, what is Butcher and Blade doing with Jack and Angelico? And there's somebody else there that makes no sense.
The private party
but,
guys.
What is he supposed to do? Elevate all these guys just because he's standing there with them? Let me just say this real quick. You make people, Billy, when they're in rivalries, when they're in feuds, when they're going back and forth on the microphone, maybe there's some bloodshed, there's some beating up in the back where you become emotionally invested in and you're like, I want this guy to win or I want this guy to get his ass kicked. That's how you make – that's how you get the guys rubbed.
You generate doubt in the fans where they – hey, Darby Allin might beat Punk. And if he beats Punk, wow, Darby Allin beat Punk. That's what you're supposed to get out of a rub. Not just like, oh, he's working with Punk and all these wrestling fake experts. Well, he's getting the rub. He's being elevated. He says, no, he's not. Look at your numbers. Your numbers are going down now because you're working with these mid-card guys. You're doing nothing to elevate them, and you're not. And you're devaluing yourself.
Billy, I'm sorry. I don't think this is Tony. I think this is Punk, but go ahead.
Yeah. All right, go ahead.
Yeah, that's the other thing. Any rub that Darby got from working with Punk is devalued by the fact that everyone's working with Punk. So
right, and that it was just one match. How can you get into just one match?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's yeah. You know what I'm saying?